Where is Peas Blossom?
Ready.
Scratch my head, Peas Blossom. where's Monsieur Cobweb?
Ready.
Monsieur Cobweb, good monsieur, get you your weapons in hand and kill me a red-hipped humblebee on the top of a thistle, monsieur. Oh, and monsieur, bring me the honey bag. Fret not yourself too much in the action, monsieur. Oh, and good monsieur, have care the honey bag break not. I would be loath to have you overflow with a honey bag, good monsieur. Where's monsieur mustard seed?
Daddy.
Give me your leaf mustard seed. Pray you, leave me your curtsies.
What you will?
None, good mustard seed, but to help carry Peas Bottom to scratch. Must be to the barber's, monsieur, for he thinks I am marvelous hairy about the face, and oh, I am such a tender ass that if my face do but tickle me, I must scratch.
I hear some music, my sweet love.
Ooh, I have a reasonably good ear for music. Let's have the tongs and the bones.
Or say, sweet love, what their desires to eat.
Truly a peck of provender. Methinks I could have your good dry oats. Methinks I have a dreadful desire to your bottle of hay. Good hay, sweet hay, half no fellow.
I have a very venturous fairy that shall seek the squirrel's hoard and fetch thee new nuts.
I have rather a handful or two of your dried peas, but pray you, let not you nor your people disturb me, for I have an exposition of sleep come upon me.
This sweet sight. Her dotage now I do begin to pity, for meeting her of late behind the woods, seeking sweet favours for this hateful fool. I did upbraid her and fall out with her, for she his hairy temples then had rounded with a coronet of fresh and fragrant flowers. And that same dew which sometime on the buds was wont to swell like round Denorian pearls, stood now within the pretty flower's eyes like tears that did their own disgrace bewail. When I had at my pleasure taunted her, and she in mild terms begged my patience, I then did ask for her changeling child, which straight she gave me, and sent her fairy to bear him to my bower in fairyland. And now I have the boy. I will undo this hateful imperfection of her eyes, and gentle Puck, take this transformed scalp off of this that you aching, when the other dew shall back to Athens again repair, and think no more of this night's accident, but as the fierce vexation of a dream. First, I will release the fairy queen. Be as thou wast wont to be. See as thou wast wont to see. Dian's bud or Cupid's flower hath such force and blessed power. Now, my Titania, wake you. Robin, take off his head.
Now with thine own fool's eyes.
Now, thou and I are new in amity, and shall tomorrow midnight solemnly dance in Jupiter Theseus' house triumphantly, and blessed to all fair prosperity. And there shall the pairs of faithful lovers be wedded with Theseus, all in jealousy.
Fair king, attend the mark. I do hear the morning lark.
Then, my queen, in silence sad, trip we after the night shade. We the globe can compass soon, swifter than the wandering moon.
Come, my lord, and in our flight, tell me how it came this night that I, sleeping here, was found with these mortals on the ground.
Since we have the bowed of the day, my love shall hear the music of my hounds.
I was with Hercules and Cadmus once, when in a wood of Crete they bayed the bear with hounds of Sparta. Never did I hear such gallant chiding, for besides the groves, the skies, the fountains, every region near seemed all one mutual cry. I never heard so musical a discord, such sweet thunder.
My hounds are bred out of the Spartan kind, so flued, so sanded, with heads hung with ears that sweep away the morning dew. Crook-kneed and dew-flaps like Sibelian bulls. Slow in pursuit, but matched in mouth like bells, each under each. A cry more tunable was never hollered to, nor cheered with horn in Crete, in Sparta, nor in Thessaly. Judge when you hear. But soft, what nymphs are these?
My lord, this is my daughter here, asleep. And this Lysander, this Demetrius is, this Helena, or Nedra's Helena. I wonder of their being here together.
No doubt they rose up early to observe the rites of May, and hearing of our intent, came here in grace of our solemnity. But speak, Aegeus. Is not this the day that Hermia should give answer to her choice?
It is, my lord.
Go bid the huntsmen to wake them with their horns. Good morrow, friends. Valentine is past. Begin these wood birds but to couple now.
Pardon, my lord.
I pray you all stand up. I know you two are rival enemies, so how come this gentle concord in this world, where hatred is so far from jealousy, to sleep by hate and fear no enmity?
My lord, I shall reply amazedly, half asleep, half waking, but as yet I swear I cannot truly say how I came here. But as I think, for truly would I speak, and I do bethink me, so it is, I came with Hermia hither. Our intent was to be gone from Athens, where we might, without the peril of the Athenian law...
Enough! Enough, my lord. You have enough. I beg the law upon his head. They would have stolen away. They would, Demetrius, thereby to have defeated you and me. You of your wife, me of my consent. Of my consent that she should be your wife.
My lord. Fair Helen told me of their stealth, of this their practice here into the wood, and I, in fury, hither followed them. Fair Helena, in fancy, followed me. But, my lord, I wot not by what power, but by some power it is. My love for Hermia, melted as the snow, seems to me as the remembrance of an idle god which in my childhood I did dote upon. And all the love, the virtue of my heart, the pleasure and the constancy of my eye, is only Helena. To her, my lord, was I betrothed, ere I saw fair Hermia, but as in sickness did I loathe this food, but as in health, with my sense returned, now I do wish it, love it, long for it, and will forevermore be true to it.
Fair lovers, you are fortunately met, and of this discourse we shall hear more anon. Aegeus, I will overbear your will, for in the temple, by and by with us, these couples shall eternally be knit. And for the morning now is something worn. Our purposed hunting shall be set aside. Away with us to Athens, free and free. We'll hold a feast in great solemnity. Come, Hippolyta.
These things seem small and ephemeral, like
humans turn to clowns?
Methinks I see things with private eye, when everything seems
dumb. So methinks, and I found Demetrius like a jewel. Mine own and not mine own.
Are you sure that we sleep? It seems to me that yet we sleep, we dream. Was not the king here? And bade us follow him.
Yea, and my father?
And Hippolyta.
And he did with Hippolyta him to the temple.
Why then we're awake. Let's follow him. And by the way, let us forget our dreams.
Oh, my God, come! Call me and I will answer. My next line is, most fair miss. Is a quince? Blue, the bellows mender. Stout, to take the starveling. God's my life. Stolen hence and left me here asleep. I've had a most rare vision. Methinks I've had a dream. Past the wit of man to say what this dream was. Man is but an ass if he is to go about and expound this dream. Methought I was, oh, but man is a patched fool if he is to say what methought I was and methought I had. Oh. Man's eyes cannot hear, his ears cannot see what, his hands cannot taste, his tongue cannot conceive, and his heart cannot report what methought my dream was. I will get Peter Quince to write a ballad of this dream. It shall be called Bottle's Dream, because it hath no bottom. And I shall sing it at the latter end of the play before the Duke. Peradventure, to make all the more sweet, I shall sing it at her death.